Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, good afternoon everybody. Welcome back to media class. It's time for me and Bu Linda actually to present our presentations about using media in online teaching. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, this is our topic today, using media in online teaching. First, I'd like to explain to you all about what is online teaching or online learning. It's according to Ananta Natayanan in 2004, described online learning as an instructional format that is mediated by some form of technology, typically the internet, and is characterized by geographical and sometimes temporal separation between instructor and student. This is I take from E. Paolo Henrietta in his journal Selecting Media for Online Learning. Well, next, according to Wallace in 2003, online courses are defined as courses that are offered entirely through the internet. And then, based on these two definitions, we can take in short that online teaching or online learning or online course, whatever the name, is a activity of teaching and learning by using internet and technology. And there are 10 particular media attributes are paramount importance for effective learning in overall courses or online-based learning courses. That is interactivity, navigability, synchronicity or asynchronicity, flexibility, media reaches, ease of use, individualizations, mobility, proximity, and responsiveness. And next, I'd like to explain to you how to teach English by, what is it, based on the skills. The first one is speaking. This is I take from Quick Start Guide to Teaching English Online. Speaking, when you teach speaking online, you can list and watch students monitor their language, give feedback, and encourage participation and engagement, just as you do in a face-to-face classroom. As well as using your voice, you can use the chat box, the whiteboard, or share document on your screen to clarify questions and interact with students. You can delay your feedback until the end of the task, or you can give immediate feedback also and support. One advantage of teaching speaking online is that you can record the class. You and your students can watch the lesson again to learn from good examples or focus on areas for improvement. And this is something like, yeah, we do now. Yeah, we can talk or speak interactively through Zoom. Yeah, and we can use this also to our student. And then one advantage from teaching speaking online, we can record it, we can upload record and upload it in YouTube, yeah, and other social media. And then when you teach reading, when you teach reading online, you need to think about replacing books and papers handouts with digital person. Many video conference platforms such as Zoom and Skype have a screen sharing feature which you can use to display the digital text. Alternatively, you can take and share a screenshot of reading material, copyright permitting. You and your students can also use the drawing tool on platform like Zoom for highlighting text. Yes. In teaching reading, we can substitute paper with with digital person like this, yeah. And then listening. When you teach listening online, it's crucial to use the right equipment. You need to check that students can listen or to videos or audio files. You can, as well as to you on most platforms, you can share audio files, which will enable all students to hear tracks clearly on their own computers. Another option is to play the track on your computer, but this will result in a lower quality audio track for students. Most listening tasks can be done online with the whole class using the whiteboard, chat box, or screen sharing features, including pre-listening, while listening, and post-listening tasks. But okay, in listening, the key patterns, the key way is we must make sure that our student can hear the tape recorder or the recording from our computer. And then writing. Teaching writing online can be fun and enjoyable if you know what tools can help you at lower levels, maybe for elementary level in your course. But you can work at sentence level using the whiteboard or share screen. At higher level, you might focus your online classes on preparing students for writing. You can use breakout rooms for pair or group discussions to help students analyze model text, come up with creativity ideas, and plan the language they will use. You may wish to set the actual writing work for independent study or set collaborative writing tasks. For example, insert the Google Docs document where a student is able to write at the same time on the same document. Yeah, this is like we practiced several weeks ago with Mr. Dion. Actually, we can write by using Google Form with collaborative writing. Yeah, and then this one, grammar and vocabulary. You can teach grammar and vocabulary in a very similar way to how you would teach it in the face-to-face classroom, exploring the structure and items through reading and listening texts, presenting them or guiding discovery using the virtual whiteboard and following up with the practice tasks. However, the online environment also gives you the opportunity to use other digital tools in lesson and for independent study. Okay, like we use some of the applications or website like Kahoot, Quizlet, Quiz Your English. We can use this to practice our students' ability in grammar and vocabulary. Okay, here I like to present us the three platforms. Three kinds of video conference that are very, very popular lately: Zoom, Google Hangout, and Microsoft Teams. We like to see this according to the number of participants in pre-features, in pre-account. Zoom can cover 100 participants, Google Hangout only 10, and Microsoft Teams 250. And then whiteboard facility in only in Zoom and Microsoft Teams, slow slides, all screen share materials and slide, and rising function. Yes, not in Google Hangouts. And in group rooms, in Zoom we have break rooms, and no group room in Google Hangouts, but in Microsoft Teams we have channels. Yeah, and then filter to add to faces, there is only in Google Hangout. And then text chat box, all have text chat box. Give stars and badges only in Microsoft Teams. And then emojis, all, yeah, if you, when you happy, when you scary, and when you are sleepy, you can send emojis to in the chat room, in chat box. And then all platforms can be free or premium subscription. And then there's one more thing that like we do in the our school that I didn't explain it here, but in my PowerPoint, we also use Google Classroom, yeah, to share the material to students. We use Google Classroom. Okay, I think that's all our explanation about teaching English online or using media in online teaching. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, or maybe you can add my explanation, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, any questions?
Pak Mahmud, can you share the reading skill again?
Reading, yeah, reading. Okay. This one?
Yes. Yeah, actually, for my personal experience, the most difficult thing to teach is reading during this online learning. Because when you give the student to read something, sometimes they just don't do that.
Yes.
They are hiding. Yeah, so maybe Pak Mahmud can share your experience with your student. I think your student is a little bit older than mine. If you have any tips or trick to do the reading.
Okay, thank you. When teaching reading, especially for reading comprehension, we also use Google Classroom. I share the text, the file in the form of image or PDF files, and then some questions, and then just collect the answer of the student and give score. And then for interactive reading, yes, with screen sharing features, actually this is enjoyable actually, but the same thing happens to my students. Yeah, I just give them, try to explain by sharing page, sharing screen, and then explain to my student. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Pak Mahmud.
Okay,
oh yeah, and then, Pak Mahmud, I will add something for the grammar point. You know, you can use a living worksheet in the website. They are also very good, for the grammar, and vocabulary.
What is it, living?
Living worksheet.
Oh, living worksheet, yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, I will try it, and then sir. Okay, Pak Kahar, any question?
I want to ask a question.
Yes.
Yeah. About teaching. About media. It can be depend on Pak Mahmud or depend on someone else. For teaching by using media, what kinds of media that the best media depend on you for teaching general English? I mean reading, grammar, and everything else. So what is the most or the best media that you use or depend on you, this is the best media for teaching, and why it is the best media, because of what, like,
okay,
that's all.
Thank you for the questions. Based on my experience, when I was teaching face to face, was it online in video conference, I think Zoom is the best for me and for us, because it is easy to use, and there are many features that we can use to help us, like whiteboard, share screen, yeah, recording, and this is the best, but the most popular one in my school, especially all of my teacher in my school use Google Classroom, but Google Classroom only what is it for sharing materials and questions. So for video conference, I think Zoom is the best and most popular one, and for another one is Google Classroom. Thank you.
It's okay, Kamamut, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for the questions. I hope our discussion can be useful for us as teachers. Thank you. I'll stop recording. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.